I will use as the Google as the starting material for any of my demos. I will start with Simago. Simago general ranking. This is the website of Simago general ranking as well as country ranking. Now I will go for only Simago general ranking. I told you that this is a useful tool for publishing or selecting a journal for publishing. You can see here, this is advertisement, but don't bother about that. I can as well remove that, but every time I do it, it comes up. Okay. So, you can see here, it has listed more than 32,000 items. But covering different kinds of items actually. We are interested, say for example, we are interested only in the journals. All types, that you select the journals. Now you see 32,000 will come down to how many items have come? 25,000 items. Now I want to submit an article, say in the subject area of business management and accounting. So I will click on to business management and accounting. Then it will list out the journals in the area of that. That 25,000 became to 1,427 items. So you can see here all these business management and accounting journals are listed in the decreasing of SGR. SGR is Simago general ranking. That is based on the data, Scopus data, these people arrived at. And this has got highest SGR value, that is 18.318, next is 18.151, 12 point something like that. This is the topmost journal. You can rearrange these journals by H index as well. The H index could be for an individual author, for a journal, or an institution, or a department. You can also have that. If I click on to this, it will rearrange the entire, you can see here, Academy of Management Annals. That's a top journal with the SGR value 18.31. If I click on to H index, it will rearrange that list. You can see on the top, you will find some other journal. See here, the Academy of Management journal came to the top. So whatever criteria you want to use for selecting the journals, either H index or SGR value or any of these things, here there is one other item, sites per document 2 years. This is almost like impact factor only, but not exactly impact factor. The value of this is almost like impact factor value only. What I will do is, I have selected the area of business management and accounting. Okay, but it covers all aspects of business management and accounting. Let's see, select the sub-subject within that. Accounting, the business and the international management, or the business management and accounting, industrial relations, management information systems, etc. I would like to go for accounting. I will click on to accounting. So 1,400 items, let's see how many items are there. Now, 150 items are there in accounting. Okay. You can see, the same, these journals are listed again in the decreasing order of SGR value. Okay, I can rearrange this this as well by H index as well. I am a researcher, a fresh research scholar. I feel that I may not get a chance to publish in international journal. So I would like to prefer an Indian journal, okay? So there is a provision here. All regions are countries. And how many items are there? 150 journals are there for accounting, which is a branch of business management and accounting. Now I will select Indian journals only. Let's go down. Brazil. India. Interestingly, I found only one journal. You can see here, Indian Math, only one journal. Its SGR value is this. It is still SGR value, although it is less than one, is a pretty good one. You can, its H index is this much. So you can as well go for this journal. So if I click on to this, it will go to the concerned page, wherein it will give the details about this. This is the case with even the earlier list as well. Finance India. This is the index research journal. These are the subject areas. These are the publishers, Indian Institute of Finance, published by Indian Institute of Finance. This is a H index, publication type. You can go to home page. If I click on to this, what it will do is it will take me to the home page of the concerned journal. You can see the scope is also there. By reading the scope, you can decide whether your article fits into this area or not. This is about the Simego journal. Now, I will once again go for Google, go for the second source. Second source I plan to go for is Base. Base Search Net. Yes. I'm going to Base, Bielefeld Academic Search Engine. Sorry, I'm drinking tea without giving a tea break for you people. Still coming up. In the meantime, let me have another sip of tea. It's slow. So, in the meantime, I'll open another site. The one I'd like to go is the CNKI. I opened the CNKI site. Base is also being opened. I don't know, some of it is a bit late. Let me try start with CNKI. For CNKI, I have taken a topic given by one of the participants as image retrieval. Let me search topic image retrieval. This is a topic given by one of the participants. So image, image retrieval. Okay. Now I will search for it. You can see here what all you can search. I told you in the beginning itself that CNKI is one of the best database of Chinese national database. They have got different databases. This is one of them. Okay, which covers journals, thesis, meeting, newspaper, yearbook, patent, standard, etc., books, etc., all those things, academic journal, etc., all those things. So I have put the search term as image retrieval. Okay, now I will search for it. Okay. I can go to advanced search, restrict the search to the title, etc. I can as well do that. You can, usually it comes in Chinese, so you can as well click on to English. At least you'll have the English abstract and that sort of things. Okay, you can see here, so many journals, journal items, so many thesis items, for 4,000 and an odd number, and out of which PhD thesis are 514, and meeting items are so many, newspaper items, 8, yearbook, books, patents, so many, China patents, overseas patent, and like that, we can as well do that. Now, what I will do is, I will select PhD thesis. Let me, out of the total items, 20,800 are totally available, out of which breakup is so many journal items, 14,000 journal items, so many theses, meeting so many, the statistics is here. So now I will select the PhD thesis only. Under thesis, again PhD, master level thesis, 3500. So I will click on to thesis alone. The very first item is research and low complexity distance metric learning method. This is for this particular topic and image retrieval. Now I will click on to this. You can see what are the things you can do with this. I can show you that as well. See, on the right side, you can see many things. You can see, you can download a list, or you can download item, etc. This cited download, you can see all those possibilities on the right side. Okay, you can see, you can click on to it. You can, how do you want to quote it? If I click on to this, it will list out the different styles of reference, and you can choose whatever you want. Okay, and also when degree or the award, when this particular PhD thesis is of 2021, this year itself, this award is only for this year. So let me see the very first thesis. Okay, I clicked on to the title. Let me see where I'll be taken. It's coming up. In the meantime, with Byerfield, yeah, Byerfield Academic Search Engine has come up. So let me finish up this. So it's taking more time. So I will try to make use of another source for my Wi-Fi connectivity. There could be some problem with that. Let me try that. I'm using my mobile Wi-Fi connectivity for this purpose. Let me see whether it's going to be faster compared to this. I'm disconnected. Come up. Now it's still coming up. Base has come up. In the base, I'll click on to advanced search. Okay, advanced search I'm using. I'm going to search on Veda. Let me see, because this is an international database maintained by German people. Let me search, are there any items on Veda? Veda. I can search the title or any other field or the entire document or by author, ASCII number, etc. All types of documents. I'm not restricting the type of data. You can search only the books or journal items or patents or thesis, etc. Or you can restrict to open access items, or you can also search worldwide items. You can see here, worldwide item, or a country specific. You can click onto this, you can select the country, or you can go for a year. Which your items you want, you can as well do that. Now I'll go down and search for it. I have not specified anything. I have not used any filter. In the meantime, yes, this particular thesis record has come up. This is in which is in English. You can see here, research and low complexity distance metric learning. This internet connection is unstable, so probably I'll be switching over back to the earlier one. Let me see till it works fine. Otherwise, I'll switch over to that. Okay, you can see here, Veda, how many items are there? 1830 items are there. So on the right side, you have got filtering parameters like subject wise. You can choose any subject within Veda, that's cultural studies or Kupur or newspaper cutting and general arts and humanities, etc. So let me not select any writer. And then you can use due decimal classification, year of publication, content provider, language. So definitely let me restrict to English language items. Out of 1,830 items, 657 items are in English. So I will select English. Okay. Now, let's see how many English items are there out of 1,800 and all. Yes, this is CNK item. You can go to the whole book.
So now you can unmute yourself, sir.
Iga ikka kelta.
Yes, sir. Please. Yes.
Okay, I'll start sharing the screen again.
Yes, please.
Kanta ide Google lo?
Yes, sir. Visible, sir.
Google can't type, can I?
Yes, sir. Can't type.
Okay, that's fine.
Please go ahead, sir.
Right. I was giving the demo on base. Start again. Okay. Now seems to be okay. I'm searching again, Veda. Search for Veda. And I am searching the title area for Veda. There are 1,830 items. I am selecting the language, English language items only. Out of 1,800 items, there are 657 items in English language. I would like to see only the thesis. How many theses are available? Let me try document type. Here I'm choosing the document type. Book part, report, thesis. 7 theses are available out of that. Let me click on to that. You can see 7 theses are there. Details of the thesis are available one by one. So I will select an item. Idiomatization of proverb, positive word compounds in Rigveda. So I will click on to this. Let's see about that. Okay. You can see all the 7 thesis titles, etc. But I will select one of them. Click on to this. Let me see this. Oh, sorry, there was some problem. It was not formed, but you should be there. I don't know. It's not coming. But I did try. Let me try another item. But let me try this once again. Because when I searched in the morning for the same topic, I have found it. It has come up. It's you can see here. Thesis, the full text is also available. So this is how we can do searching this one. Now I'll click on to PDF of that. Sometimes the synopsis will be there. Sometimes the entire thesis will be available. Sometimes it takes you to the concerned, the public, the university site, wherein you can have the full text of the entire thesis or chapter wise or only the synopsis or whatever it is. You can have a look at it. So this is the thesis you can see here. See the contents, all the entire things are there. This is a 44-page item. Okay, this is about base. Now I will go for next item. I'll search NList. This is for those people who are working in colleges. So this is NList. I told you this gives access to more than 164,000 books and 6,000 journals. I will log in using somebody's credentials. So these are the sources, as I told you. You can as well go and search for it. Only thing is, you cannot search the content of the journal, 6,000 journals, but you can definitely search the all the e-books. So I will try to search for a book. It says nuclear physics. I'm searching for nuclear physics. So I will select only the title area. Otherwise, there will be a huge number. I will select only the title area, wherever the nuclear physics word has occurred in the title. So this is how many items are there. There are quite a good number of items, 34 heavy ions, 10 like that. 34 books have been thrown up. Totally 89 items are there on nuclear physics. I can go and show this and click on to this and see, click to view. I will click on to this particular item, for example, published in 1986. This is published in 2013. I will click on to click view. This is a, this says time block, but which is not the case. It should throw up. Let me try again. To tell like that, but definitely I'm sure I'll get it. Yes, but it's asking for the login again. Putting the log password. Some publishers, they don't ask the login once again. Some publishers do ask for the login again. So once again, I have given the login. Yes, the nuclear physics exploring the heart of matter. The entire book has come. You can read it online. You can download the book. And this is through NList. So all those 164,000 books you can search, including the recent books. So the librarians should be aware of this, and they should train their faculty members and the students to download the books as well. Okay, now I'll go for another source. This is about NList. I will not go for searching the journals because there is no search facility for the journals. I can as well go to see what you can do is, as far as the NLIST is concerned, I have already logged in using the credential. You can click on to JSTOR or anything. For example, let me start with a JSTOR or any other publisher. I can as well do that. Okay, once again, I have to log it. I'm searching the individual publishers. JSTOR, it's a low-cost database. Sometimes you get the journals which are a bit old, 6 months old or something that kind. This is the JSTOR, which covers more than 3,000 journals. You can go to advanced search and search for any topic. I will search network marketing. I am searching. You can search all fields, or you can search only the item title, or I can search the abstract. Okay. You can search articles, or you can search in all languages, or year wise, year, etc. You can do that. You can select the subject areas also. You can see here quite a good number of subject areas there. For example, archaeology, American Indian studies, bibliography, business, all sort of things. I suppose I select business one. I will go for and search in so many areas you can search for that. Submit the advanced search. I found 18 just only selecting to the those particular journals. If I were not to restrict, probably I would have got more. This is then happily relationship marketing and network economy. Just click on to this, you will have the full text of that. So you don't have, I will not do that as well. Now I'll go for another source. Once again, I'll go to Google and I'll go for a source called Internet Archive. Internet Archive. Somebody has given me a topic called on Vedic mantras. Let me search for it. This gives access to 5 billion web pages. You can see here so many web items, so many texts, 32 million texts, and so many films, videos, so many million different kinds of documents or the music, etc. All those things you'll find. So let me click on to advanced search. You can see here, if you go down, you'll see different libraries, American libraries. Each library is a huge library, Canadian libraries, music archive, electric sheep, and so many thousands of them are there. You can see here, so many items are there. So let me not get into that. Straightway, let me go for advanced search. I can search the title area or entire field or anything of that kind. I will not do that. I will search only the title area for Vedic mantras. Somebody has given this topic. Vedic Vedic mantras. I'm searching for Vedic mantras. If the title contains these two words, Vedic mantra, then only it will pick up. Simply otherwise, if I were to select any field, then it will definitely yield more number of items. I will not do that. I will select only the title area. How many items I found? 16 items are there. Out of that, 8 are audios. How many? 8 are 6. If I 8 are text. If I click on to this, it will pick up only the audios. But if I don't do that, all of them are here. You can see here. These are all the audios. For example, these are all the audios. These are all the different books, etc. Books are some other kinds of document. You can see here, Vedic variants, special publication. Let me click on to this, some special publication. Sometimes you will find the items published in 1500, 400 years back, 500 years back, 300 years back, 100 years back. If suppose you are searching for a classic book, for example, Origin of Species by Charles Darwin, even your library may not have that book at all. So you come to this source, search for Origin of Species by Charles Darwin, you'll have the full text of that. Suppose you are searching for a book on by Newton, you can have it. Mathematica, you can find it there. Or you are doing some research on philosophy. You would like to have access to your research is on Shankaracharya, for example. You can search by Shankaracharya also. You can have a lot of items on Shankaracharya. So here I have not done that. I use the topic Vedic mantras. So I will click on to one of the items. So I can make a bigger size. So I can flip the pages. You can see I can happily flip the pages. But more importantly, I can make the system to read it loudly for us. This is a very, very useful source for handicapped people, hearing and those people who can't hear at all, or those people who can't read it, blind people, etc. It's a very useful one. So now I will click on to this to read it loudly.
Cases in which the given mantra passage
I hope
composed you under are certain definite circumstances
to the reading.
Later on adapted and changed to serve a new purpose.
That's
furthermore,
beginning
literary production
okay.
is often in a high
now
degree
of
and mechanical trait which it shares with most religious literature.
I'll stop this. Now I'll go for one Vedic mantras audio. Community audio, something like that, Vedic mantra, something like that. I'll click on to this. Let's see about that. This is just audio. You can see here. I'll play the audio.
Vanshi Vibhushit Kara Navanirata.
Okay, that's about Internet Archive. Now I will go for another source, Google Scholar. You may wonder why Gaudari is showing demo on Google Scholar, but you'll find that some of you, if not all, that you will have some good features of Google Scholar as well. You can see I can use it as a two different kind of a source. One is for selecting the journals for publication. So on the left side, you've got three bars. So click on to that. Then you have metrics. You have advanced search, my profile. So if I click on to my profile, you'll see here. You'll see my profile, Gaudar's profile. You can see here. My profile, this is of course a old one when I was at University of Mysore. You can see here, this particular item, emerging pricing models for e-journals, consortia and Indian initiatives, authored by myself and my colleague, Poonima Narayan, and which has been cited 31 times. I hope Poonima is also attending this program. I don't know, I'm not sure about it. I'm sure she would have been there. And the number of citations, H index is 5, all those things are here. Okay, these are the citations received year wise. That's about my profile. So this is, anybody can create one's own profile. Why all of a sudden, by clicking my profile came up is, I have opened, I am with my email. You can see here, my email has been opened. That's why it has automatically picked up my profile. I did not plan for it, automatically it has picked up. Anybody having even one publication can have his or her profile. Okay, it will be a very good thing because that will have an URL. Simply copy and paste the URL in your, say for example, in your signature, email signature. Then after 6 months, somebody clicks onto that link, it will pick up the updated profile of yours after 6 months. And that's a beautiful way of doing it. Okay. Now I will go for metrics. The Google metrics. You can see here, the top one is Nature with the HPI index. So this is the Google Scholar metrics HPI index. Top is this one. And you can have many more things. You can go down and select the journal of your choice. The page-wise number of items are there. So I will not get into the details. If you want to view all, you can view all and go for that. See, the entire list is there. Wherever your article fits into it, but depending upon the Google Scholar metrics, you can decide for selecting the journals. Okay, now I will go for, okay. Advanced search. I will not go use advanced search. I'll simply go for general search. I will search for, somebody has given me a topic, machine learning, crop yield. So I will search for that. Somebody has given me this machine learning and crop yield prediction, whatever it is. It has thrown up 65,600 items. If I were to restrict the search to the title, probably I'd have got less number of items. So anyway, I'm not here to teach you the search techniques. While I am doing that, probably one by one, sometime I'll be using advanced search, sometime I'll be using a general search. You can try on your own. Okay. So the first item, for example, you can see here. This doesn't have a link to the full text. See, all those 65,000 items have been listed one below the other. Usually, the top cited items will be on the top. This particular item has received 357 items. This means this is definitely a good item for you because so many citations it has received. So what all things you can do using this? If you click on to this, it will list out all the 357 items. Okay. Then again, all those 357 items will be listed in the decreasing order of the number of citations received. So you can go on clicking. She is my relative. He is her relative. In that way, you go on collecting the items. And that's how also you can build up your literature review collection. So I will not do this. Now I'll click onto this. You can see your site. If I click onto this, you see what will happen. It has listed this particular reference in MLA style, APA style, Chicago style, Harvard style, or Vancouver style. If you are following the MLA style, you just copy and paste and use it. That one. That's the one purpose of that. Now, on the right side, you have got a link here. You can see here machine learning methods for crop yield prediction. I will click on to this. Let me click on to this. Having the full text access is there. See, it has come up. Environmental search. The full text item has come up. So happily, by clicking this, you can download to your local system and enjoy it. Okay. Now I will go for something else. You can see that's how whenever on the right side you have got link. For example, this one. You click on this one, you will have the full text of this. So all those items having this link will have the full text. Suppose it's not there. So what you will do, let me try. Okay. Here is an item for which there is no link. So I will click on to this. This is an Elsevier item published in 2018. Okay. So I will click on to this. Okay. This has come up. So if I want to view or read the PDF, it will ask for $30, $40, like that. So what I will do is, I will, there is a, down below, there is a DOI link, DOI.org. The different publishers give this DOI link in different places. Some publishers give at the end of the citations. Some people give, some publishers will give immediately after the title and author, etc. It depends upon the publisher's policy. So what I would do is, I will click on to this and copy the link address. I am just copying the link address. I will go for Sci-Hub. Once again, I would like to tell you that this is what Sci-Hub gives. How to use, whether to use or not, it is left up to you. I will not commit or anything, but it should not be a problem for academic people to make use of it. I have already copied this item. You can see I have copied this item, DOI, and I am pasting it in this box. And then I'm trying to open it, okay? This is actually to remove all barriers in the way of science. This is a paywall-free hub, okay? I'll click onto them. Just see here, let's see whether, full text has come up. This is an Elsevier item, full text has come up. You simply go here, download it to your local system and continue your research work. That's how it works. Okay, now this is, spoke about the Google Scholar and different ways in what way Google Scholar could be used. Now I will go for commercial database JGate. I'll go for JGate. I have credentials for JGate. So straightway I will go for JGate. I will log in. So it has got a separate link for the COVID-19 related items as well. If I click onto that, it will list out the thousands and thousands of items on coronavirus related things. I will not do that. This is a wonderful database which covers something around 51,000 journals, more than 51,000 journals. Let us see how many journals are covered in which subject areas. These are all the main subject areas. So what I will do is I will browse A to Z. The different subjects, sub-subjects are there. How many items are there? There are more than 53,000 items, including the journals and other things, peer-reviewed and otherwise non-peer-reviewed journals are also there. So I will restrict the search to peer-reviewed journal only. Let me apply the filters. Let's see how many items are there. There are, out of 53,000, 51,900 are peer-reviewed titles. And then out of this, how many open access journals, how many open access Indian journals are there? So I will, or how many Indian journals are there? Only Indian journals. I will click on to only Indian journals. Now I click on to that. Let's see how many Indian journals are there. Out of that, how many are peer-reviewed? It's already there. These are all peer-reviewed journals only. Now I click on to open access. Let me see how many open access items Indian journals are there. Let me try that. Okay. Let's see about that. 3,711 items, journal items. Okay. So this covers more than 3,700 Indian journals which are open access. So open access content of Indian journals is almost 2/3 of the entire thing. So that's the thing. So if you are subscribing to JGate, you can have access to all these items. But it's a bigger database. It will throw up all the items which are available open access, irrespective of whether it is through open access journal or for having access to your own institution by subscribing to that journal. Or if you are a Shodashindu facilitated university, you can, whatever Shodashindu gives access, you can directly have it. So whenever I search on any topic, it will take care of all the items for which you have got access, whether it's access through your consortia. If you are a VTU consortia member, it will throw up that as well. If you are, if it is an open access journal, then also it will throw up. If it is a from a journal for which only one article is available in open access out of a particular issue, that also will be thrown up. So it will care of all, take care of all this. So I will go for advanced search. Let me search on something. Somebody has requested an item on social media. C-I-A-L-I-J, social media, consumer behavior. C-O-N-S-U-M-E-R. Consumer behavior. Sometimes behavior spelling, we'll have to take care of that spelling behavior. I hope the system will take care of that as well. So I will not select the fields of searching. I'll simply search. Later on, we can restrict if the number of items are more. Or I can select search for social media consumer behavior. It may be for the management sciences or arts and humanities, anything of that kind. So I will not bother about that. I'll simply search for it. Or for which I can restrict it to the search only the full text only items. I can as well do that. Or peer reviewed or only professional, like that. So I will not use any filter. I will search for it. So how many items I could get? Some 4 items only. All the items are available with the full text. Okay, that's the thing. Okay, I will probably use the behavior, social behavior word as I had used. It may yield more items. I could get not more actually. Only 4 items are there. Okay, you can see here all 4. Sometimes this have been hundreds. What I will do is I will take a little bit broader topic, or because I used 4 keywords in the this one. Social media. I will not go for other aspect of it. I'll click search only for social media. Let's see, there will be huge number. I'm sure about it. There will be huge number of people. Oh my God, you can see here. The number of items are only 73,000. Out of which full text is available for 36,000 items. So we can restrict it to, say, for example, I would like to go for only business management items or information science and sociology of aspect of it, education, behavioral science or management or something like marketing and sales, for example. This being the consumer behavior, let me restrict it to management, sales and business management items. So I will apply the filters for that. Number is a little bit, it will have come down. So from 76,000, it has come down to 10,000 items, out of which nearly 40% are having full text access. So what I would do is I will click on to one of them. See, all those items are listed here. If I click on to this, it will throw up the abstract and other details. If I click on to this subject, you can see here, the Venn diagram has thrown up with a breakup of subject. So what is the, how many items are there in each of these subjects? Finance, so many, trade, component, commerce, 949. If I click on to this, it will throw up the concerned items. Now I can also click on to journals. You can see here, this particular journal has got 262 items on the search topic, different journals. So when you are carrying out the literature review, it's worthwhile for you to also, so how many items you have taken from each of these publishers or the journals, you can as well do that. Okay, I will not do that. Let me come down. Or if I click on to this, it will list out only those items down below for having full text access. I will not do that. Okay, I will click on to the first one. Let's see whether the full text is there for that or not. No, it doesn't have a full text. You can see here, it's locked. So most important thing, one of the best the feature of JGET is all the items, whatever it was, all those 10,000 items, it has listed by the SGR value of that. So having an SGR value itself is a quality of that particular item. The search index is 27. That means it's a good item. So it lists out 10,000 items, but you may be thinking, why should I bother about 10,000 items? So you just bother about the items having SGR value. Okay. So, but unfortunately, this doesn't have full text access. Okay, you can see here, it doesn't have full text access. You can download those things, etc., a lot of things. If there is no full text access, subscription is required. Sometimes, if it is available in another library, it will show that as well. Okay, now I'll click on to the other item. Let's see whether there is a, no, it's also a, doesn't have access to full text access. No. To another item. Full text access is there. No. Unfortunately, putting hand only on items not having the full text access. So I will rather click on to this full text access only. Let me see. In the first page, there were no items. Now, definitely, it will have full text access. Click on to any item. I'll click on to this, for example. Here, full text access is there. If I click on to this, you will have the full text access. Even this is having SGR value, which index is so much. So that means this is a very good item for you to read. So I will click on to that, or you can click on to the abstract. Okay. Article full text. Can happily download this item by clicking onto this, because it is an open access item. That should not be a problem at all. So this is about JGET. Now I will go for next item. Now I will go for a commercial database, ScienceDirect. You may wonder why Gaurav is teaching us about ScienceDirect. Well, I told you that all these commercial publishers have certain percentage of content in the open access channels. So I will go for that. Let me, somebody had requested a search to be done on healthcare access. Okay, I will try to search that one. I can, without specifying any field, I can put the words here, but I'll go for title search because it will be a huge one. So I will go for title search, that is healthcare access. I'm searching for healthcare access. Mind you, I'm searching a commercial database. Commercial database I'm searching for which you may not have access at all. You don't have to have any access to ScienceDirect. Use ScienceDirect for searching level, it is open access. If the full text is behind the paywall, you'll have to pay the money, this one, or get it. Or you'll have to go to a campus for wherein the access is there for that particular journal, you can download that. Otherwise, you can take the remote access facility and do it. That's a different matter. But for this, you don't have to do anything. I will only search for this healthcare access. Okay. Let's see how many items have come. 267 items have come. You can hear year-wise breakup and the article type out of that. See, if you click onto this, it will drop only those four review articles. So the research articles, so many. So book chapters, so many. The publication title, value in health, etc. A lot of many things are there. So you can see here. This first is research article, no access. Second is also no access. Yes, still now there this was not there. Now if you click on to this, it will throw the full text. Whenever there is a PDF symbol here like this, that means it, you have got access to that. You're not subscribing to any Elsevier journal, but still you have got access to PDF. So if you click on to this, you will have definitely full text. But this doesn't have. But this has got an SSH. If I click on to that, it will throw up the full text, or it will take me to the, yes, it has already come up. See. It has come up, 15 page item is there. Okay, that's how even the, this is what I was telling you when I was talking in the slide presentation, the open access content of the commercial publisher, this is one of them. Okay, so that's enough. Now I will go to Emerald. Emerald is a good source for LIS people, library science people, as well as the management people. Okay, you can go for browse our content, or you can search for it. There may be an advanced search facility as well. So you can go to advanced search here. Yes, it's there. Enter your search term. I'll search once again network marketing. Or I'll take something related to library science. Search support services, research support services. So I will go for searching the search, all the Emerald content, journal articles. So all the Emerald content only, let me search for it. Now I'll search for it. Yes, there are quite a good number of items out there. So this one you can see here, in the right side you have got a link to the full text. If it is available free of charge, you can download it. Otherwise, if it is not available, no way, you have to pay and get it, or go to a library wherein you have got access to Emerald. Okay, that's about Emerald. I will go for next item. Okay. DOAJ, Directory of Open Access Journal. DOAJ.org. So here I can search for some topic. So I'll not search for journals, I'll search for articles. Okay. Somebody had given me a topic, hospitality tourism. Hospitality tourism. I will not restrict you to any field. Let me search. See how many items already hit the platform. Okay. More than 3,900, so many indexed articles are there. Now I will restrict it to, see, this is how you can go on improving your search technology or search method. If you feel that the number of items are too many, you can go for the advanced search, and within that you can search for the title level searching or abstract level searching or the keyword searching. So let me do that. Let me search 3,995 items are there. Now I'll go for keyword searching. Okay, let me see how many items are there. 216 items are there, and told from 3,000, nearly 4,000, it came down to 216 items. Still, you feel that too, reading 216 items is too much for you, go for title level searching. Title level searching. 147 items are there. You can see 147 items. Now, the title is there, details are there, abstract. If you click on it, it will throw up the abstract. You can read it online. You can see it. You can read it online. Okay, I'll click on to this. Let's see about this. This is anything that you see here. It will have the full text access. Unfortunately, this is another language. Probably I would have restricted the search to English language items. Anyway, the search mechanism is the same thing. Okay. Okay. So that's about the DOAJ. I'll remove so many search boxes are there. Okay. Okay. Now, next item, I'll be taking it on Carrot 2. Carrot 2. Carrot 2 search results. It is a cluster search engine. You can see here, you can search the entire web bar, you can search PubMed. Okay. I'll take some item. Somebody has given a topic, lung cancer classification. Lung cancer classification. Okay. Lung cancer classification. The options available. Okay, let me not do that. Simply let me search. Let's see how many items are there of that. Web searcher. It's not just PubMed. It has thrown up so many items. All items together is 119 items. The classification, so many items. Cell, so many, 44. Small cell lung cancer, so many. You can as well do that. If I restrict the, go to the PubMed search, let's see about that. This is a web search. Now I'm going for PubMed search. PubMed is a well-known database for medical related. The topic itself is lung cancer related. Naturally, it has got more number of items. 100 items. Patient lung cancer study, 99 items. Clinical studies, 49, like that. This is actually different clusters. You know, each one is a cluster. So I can put it in the tree map. Let me see how can I can put it in tree map presentation. Yes. See, this is one machine learning 20. And significantly 47, clinical 49, analysis 47, overall survival so many. You can see that. Or you can generate a pie chart of that, out of the results. See, patient so many, clinical so many. Again, sub-subject within that, you can see here, you can see all those things. So from here, you can go to the concerned item. See, one of the item, I click onto that. Let me see whether I get the full text out of that. Yes, it's a PubMed item. It may have access to the full text or may not have. It depends. Citing, if I click onto that, you'll have to cite in this using this particular pattern. Abstract details are there. If the full text accessible to indicate somewhere, otherwise, no figures, etc. I don't know whether the full text is follow NCBI, mesh, etc. It may or may not have the full text access. I don't know. I did not check whether it's there or not. Anyway, that's how we can go to use Carrot 2. Now I'll go for another item, RIPEC. There may be some economics people, research papers in economics. This is a repository. You can go to this. You can 102 countries. You can search or you can browse. You can do anything of that kind. It takes the content from EconLit, Econ Store, and many other things, etc. You can do many things with this. But anyway, I will not go on doing further things in this. I will go to SSRM because I want to have some discussion at least for 10 to 15 minutes. Is already 12:35 or so. Let me SSRN, Social Science Research Network. SSRN homework. This is of course Elsevier product. You can browse. You can do search. Lot of things. Lot many things. You can see here, you can also down below, there is a search facility. You can see here down below, there is a search facility, applied sciences like that. A lot many things you can, go to advanced search, put some title, say economics, say behavioral economics, B-E-H-A-V-I-O-U-R-L, behavioral economics, okay. I'll click on to that. Let's see if there are any items on that. Yeah, there are 599 items. see, so many people have downloaded, and if you click onto that, you'll get the full text, because this is a repository, not necessarily before publishing the article, but you can see this is already published, and this is 2000 items. You can have the full text by clicking onto that. This is about SSRM. I'll go for another one. Directory of Open Access Books. I'll be a bit faster. Otherwise, I will not have any time for the discussion. DOAB, Directory of Open Access Books. I can search the books in the right. You can see here more than 43,000 academic peer-reviewed books from 656 publishers. What do you mean by 656 publishers? What these publishers do is, for example, Springer, it publishes so many books. They have more than 2 lakh books published. And out of that, certain percentage of books, they may leave it for the open access. That, those things are being made available through DOAB. And DOAB gives a search facility and gives the facility for downloading that those books through their publisher's site or anything like that. So I will search for some books. For example, I'll search for the chemistry. So, chemistry books. How many books are there? Or I can go for analytical chemistry, something like that. These are all the books. Okay. You can also browse through that. Okay. Search as browse through that. In the meantime, I'll have to open another source. Okay. There are 862 books on chemistry. The first one is analytical chemistry. If I search analytical chemistry, probably I would have got less number of items. I search chemistry. There are more number of books on chemistry. Recent advances in chemistry. Published recently, 2019, you can see here. And this is 2018, symmetry and mathematical treatment in chemistry. Okay. You can click onto this. And it will take you to some other site wherein you can download the full text or anything of that kind. Again, you can read the books or something that can, whatever you want, you can do as well. Now, I will go for some other. I also told you that there are a number of OERs, Open Education Resources. I will select one or two of them and try to do something for that. Okay. I will search open stacks. Okay. OpenStacks. Open stacks. This is one of the OER source. You can see here. You will help us to read most ones, subjects, different subjects, mathematics, etc. Get started now. Okay, let's see about that. More than just books, something of that kind. Okay, you can browse through subject. Let's click on to this mathematics. Let's see about that. See the books on mathematics, algebra, trigonometry, calculus, volume 1, 2, 3, and again, so many books are there in that. Okay. Statistics or something like that. Okay, let me click on to pre-algebra. Okay, click on to that. Table of content. We online download the full text. So I click on to the table of content. You don't have to download the entire book. You can click on to the table of contents and go for select downloading a particular chapter or anything of that kind. Okay. You click on to this, it will facilitate you to download the full text of that particular chapter. The part of the part, chapter number 2, use of the language of algebra. Okay, that way it helps you to. This is open stacks. Okay, you can see open stacks. Okay, this is one source. Now let me try one of the learning course. This one I will. Lumen learning. Lumenlearning.com. You can see here the tools that improve teaching and learning. These are the, you can have the course for search our catalog, you can search them, you can browse them, lot many things you can do. Search our catalog. See, you can see here for 50 plus college subjects. Okay, search our catalog. Let me click onto that. So you can see here subject wise: business, English, humanities, language, mathematics, and the natural sciences, social sciences, technology, and transitional studies. Okay, let me click on to business. Let's see about that. These are the courses. Courses you can see here. Business courses you can see here. Accounting for managers. This shows accounting for managers. In accounting for managers, students learn the basic accounting principles needed to effectively make business decisions as a manager. Okay, business communication. Okay, you can click on to this our computer applications. Okay, let me click on to computer applications. Let's see about that. See, this is a, they view the course content and the outcomes. Okay, explore this course. Okay, can you see here? Additional course features that developed by so and so. What people say about this teaching with the Lumen course materials. Okay, let me see on the top for instructors, everything related to the course. This one, explore this, completely explore this, view the course content. And the outcome, let me click on to this. See, introduction to about this course, the course content and at a glance, faculty resources, and the course resources overview. Even the books used for that particular course, you'll find somewhere here. You'll find the links to that as well. Okay. The introduction to hyperlinks, putting the assignment, etc. See, assignment details are also there. Let me click on to about this course. Let me see this describes this. And module 3, the cloud computing applications. I will click on to this. So, this is the thing. Okay, you will have a lot many things. You know, you need to explore that. You will have even the assignments, etc. All those things you can explore. So I think I'm getting late. I will go for one search engine which is useful for searching the OER, that's open access educational resources. That is Mason OER MetaFinder. The OER MetaFinder. Okay. This is a meta search engine for searching OERs. OERs include the courses, the textbooks, and lot many videos, audio, lot many things, and any subject you search for. Okay. So let me go for that search engine. Okay. Catalog, scholarly communication, open access publishing, publishing services, publication, news, about workshop, etc. Somewhere there is a search facility, I remember. Catalog. Yeah, somewhere must be somewhere here. Where I click on to this, let's see whether I will get into the search and aspect. This is the main one in this one. Yeah, here is the search page for that. Okay, let me search on something, full record, rather title. Title I use as something, I should say, chemistry and somebody has requested, let me see what rural tourism, let me see, is there any item on rural tourism? Somebody had requested this. I don't know, I'm taking a rural tourism. Okay, I'm trying to search it. Let me see if there are any items on rural searching. Yeah, 151 top results, 249 results from 412 items are there, tourism in rural areas. So it's a book, a PDF you can download, and a lot many things you can do. You can go to contents page of that as well. So now, for example, if I click onto that, probably it will leave for me to see the contents page. I don't know, I'm not discovered. I'm also experimenting with you people with this particular source now today. Yeah, the entire thing has already come up, with a particular chapter has come up. Okay, additional results. So I can as well, if it's a book, happily you can download. If it is a PDF item, whatever it is, it's a article or anything of that kind, you can as well do that. But let's see about this book. Discover unlimited multimedia content. Yeah, entire book itself, I think one chapter or something like that. Anyway, that's about the OER search engine. I come to the end of my this one. But anyway, before I end up, I would like to show one thing which I thought I could do. If the time permits, I will do that as well now. I will search for Scopus database. Okay. I'm using my credentials through NAL. This is not open access anyway, but it will have a lot of open access content, as I told you, Scopus, one slide I have shown you. Now I'll click on to login. Okay, I can search the Scopus or Web of Science or anything of that kind. Let me search the Scopus itself. So I can search the topics. I can search by authors. I can search by affiliation. Or I can go for advanced search and do anything of that kind. So what I would do is I will go for advanced search. I will search by affiliation city. Okay. I will try to search the Mandya items. I will search MANDYA, Mandya. I'm searching the, I'm not searching PS college. I'm searching entire Mandya, okay? I can search Bangalore also, entire Bangalore, all the items will come. That will be a huge number. Let me search only Mandya. Let me do that. Let's see how many items are there on Mandya as covered in Scopus. There could be other institutions in 1450 items are there. These are all the items published by all institutions in Mandya together. Out of that, we can see if I click on to this, it will pick up all those 297 which are open access. Okay. Out of that, gold open access, hybrid, gold, bronze, etc., year wise breakup, the authors, and the subject areas, engineering, chemistry, etc., document types, the affiliation. Let's click on to the affiliation. Let's see. The PS College itself is number one. With that, of course, there could be no more items on PS College. Let me click on to PS College. Taking some time. I hope it will come through. Taking more time, I don't know. I'll go back and let me try to do something different, okay? No, this is wrong. Actually, yes, I cannot use that at all. I use wrong this one. I have to use affiliation and then put the PS College. Okay. Is a PS College. PS College of Engineering, Mandya. Okay. Now I'm clicking onto that. There are 423 items by PS College of Engineering. You can see here. This is the subject breakup, subject wise breakup here. 423 items published by PS College Mandya by 162 members. Now I'll click on to 423 items. Let me see. Yeah, all the items have been listed here. I can, the recent one is on the top of it. So I can as well make the other way around. You can see here on the left side the year wise open access items and the Ravindra, of course, ex principal of the college having the highest number of publications. Dr. Sridhar, who was the vice chancellor of this one, is a second author like that. Okay, the document type and so many things are there. I will not do that. So I can rearrange these items in the highest cited first. These 400 and odd items, the top one is this particular published in 97, which has got which has received a good number of this one. This, for example, this third item has received 54 citations. If I click on to this, it will throw up all those 54 citations. Okay. So what I would do is I will try to generate some indices out of that. So I'm selecting all the items. Okay, then I can download them or export them. I can view the citation overview. I can do a lot many things. Say, see the citations received by these 423 items. So I will see the view citation overview. You'll see the citation overview, its search index, and that of all that sort of things. These are the year citations received for the last 4 or 5 years, year wise. In 21, 20, of course, maximum number of citations. 21 are yet to come. You can see here its H index is 20. You can see the H graph as well. H index graph. You can see here this is the H index of PS College of Engineering. I'll go back and show a few more things very fast in another 1 or 2 minutes only, not more than that. So I have selected all once again. What I will do is I'll go for analyzing the results. Then interesting thing, that's why I'm trying to show those things to you people. So the year-wise publications, you can see here, year-wise publications of PES. I can go by subject, I can go for country, I can go for affiliation. Say I will select a country. Okay, you can see here I will remove India. They have so many papers, some four papers in collaboration with Canada, United States, MN, so many. China hardly only one item. You please note that they have one publication in collaboration with China. Okay, that's an interesting thing. Okay, now I will go back and I can as well just remember that China's case. These are the journals published and the institutions by author, who is the top author, etc. You find there. These are the funding sponsor. If I click on to that, you will find the documents by funding sponsor. The Ministry of HRD, they have got 14 papers with the support of Ministry of HRD. All those things you can have it. Okay. Now I will go back to the results. Remember that I thought the saved search is there, but it's not there. No, it's not there anyway. Let me not get into that. I wanted to show something else. Okay, it's time now. I'm sorry. I thought I would show the citing countries. Definitely, China was fourth or fifth collaborating with PS College of Engineering. If I go to the citing papers, China will come on to the top, possibly. So with that, I would like to end my demo. Now I'll stop for sharing. People can ask me some questions. Ram, can you see me now?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You're visible.
Thank you, sir. You can ask the people to ask questions directly or through chat box, whatever is possible. You can try to do that.
Yes. Participants, are you having any questions? If you're having any questions, please post your questions on the chat box. We'll take it up for the discussion.
Or they can as well come online.
Yeah, of course, you'll be given a chance to speak to our respected resource person, Dr. Iron Goder, sir, directly on this Zoom meeting. So if you wish to ask question directly, please post your details on the chat box.
I'm sorry, I used minute by minute all the 3 hours.
Sir, in fact, the chat box is flooded with appreciations and compliments rather than posting the questions. However, I could hardly find 3 questions, which are very general in nature. Mm-hmm. The question asked by Tanya Sharma is, why some of the articles will not come up on Sci-Hub? It will only show blank page whenever they use this database to search with the DOI number.
Yeah. In fact, this was not the case earlier. Probably after getting to the court case, some they have given in writing to the court that now onwards they will not do something like that. In the process could be such a kind of thing would have happened. Even I too had experience of that kind. But you can see just now I showed the very recent items. And I also tried today, there were some items which are in press, even Elsevier items in press. Not yet published, it's there, it's in press. Even those items, we could download that. So it's a chance. I don't say there's a strong reason for that. Could be legal problem or anything of that kind. There could be a technical problem as well. Now what's happening is, sometimes I give the DOI, but the DOI takes to the DOI of the concerned publisher's site. That happens many a times. Now, if that is the case, you'll go to the publisher's site, but you may not get the full text at all. If it searches through Sci-Hub's content, it probably will throw up that. Now, so how Sci-Hub works? Sci-Hub people, what they have done is, they have taken the access of so many credentials of different faculty members all over the world. Through that, they pull up and they put all the full text available through that their site. and that's how it is up. That way, a particular item, what one has seen, probably would have missed that. I don't know. I really can't say exact reason, but it could be non-availability, could be legal problem, being slow, something of that kind. Okay.
Sir, Mr. Biresh Kumar asks, how to select the most suitable paper out of comprehensive results of search engine? How to select the most suitable paper? Is there any criteria to select the suitable
paper? Already I told you. Say, for example, if you search Google Scholar, if there are 3,000 items, it will search, it will list out all those 3,000 items with the highest, an item having highest number of citations in the proper. Then next highest, then next highest. You can as well do that way. That's one thing. And if you go to Scopus, for example, just now I showed you that, okay? If I were to search any topic like lung cancer, so it will list out all those few thousand items on lung cancer, and we can arrange those 3,000 items in the decreasing order of number of citations received by them. So that's how you can rank the items. Even for example, JGate I showed. So JGate also has a facility of article level SJR value. It has got the facility of giving it. So that way we can do that. So different databases have got different ways of doing it. Okay, that's how it happens. Okay, wherever the citations are there, that becomes one of the items. Next is probably subject wise, year wise, and so many ways you can rank them and try to make use of them. Or if you are searching on a particular topic, if there are five or six different aspects of your work, you can give priority for a particular aspect and then try to read it. You can devise your own way of ranking them unless the citations are there. Okay, that's all. Okay, I think I answered your
Yes, sir. Another question asked by Dr. Prakash is, how to assess the authenticity of the resources, credibility of the resources which is available in the internet?
Can you tell me once again?
Sir, how to assess the authenticity of the resources available in the internet?
Okay, that's not a big thing, actually. Whether it is, even if you get it from web, I tell you, it's a very, very pertinent and very, very important question, I should say. Because, you know, whenever you are searching Google or Google Scholar, even suppose a particular person has put an article, not at all published by him in any journal. So he can as well put it through his library website or the institutional website as his personal website. If Google or the Google Scholar doesn't differentiate between this and that. So first of all, we should see whether that particular item is published in something, some journal. Second thing is whether, even if it is not published, whether it is presented in some conference or something. If it is presented in a conference or something, that can whether it has been deposited in a particular IR or not. So these are all few things, but there are other ways of doing it. So you can also see the, if suppose it is an article published in a journal. Not all the journals are quality journals. There could be low quality journals as well. So I showed you, and if it is from a journal, what you do is you copy the title of the journal, first thing. Then go to predatoryjournals.com. There you can search for that particular title, journal title. If it is there, definitely it is a predatory journal. It is a useless thing. You should not go for that. Other thing is, for research scholars who are in our country, they need to care for UGC CARE. So you take that journal title, go to UGC CARE site, simply put Google UGC CARE list, then you will end up in you can open that UGC Care site. First time you are accessing means you need to log in. No need for any payment or anything of that kind. You have to register. Then copy and paste the title of the journal in the UGC Care search box. Then you search for it. If it is no any title, that means that is not a good title for you to publish. So in that way, or publish or even follow many a times. Following it doesn't matter if it is a good article. Sometimes if it is not available in UGC Care, but still it may be a good item. So UGC Care is not a big bible by itself, but only question of getting the benefits out of that for the assessment or the recruitment itself. Still, I strongly feel that UGC Care list still needs a lot of thought, and they need to do something more than that. In fact, I had a lengthy discussion with Professor Patwardhan, who is the person behind this UGC Care list. He was the person in Pune, some university. Later on, he became the UGC Vice Chairman. I had almost 3 hours discussion with him. He agreed with my suggestions, but still they have a long way to go. For example, ICR publishes quite a good number of journals, Indian Council of Agriculturists. Interestingly, not even one title of ICR you will find in UGC Care. So many times UGC Care people may feel that let ICR approach us. See, they should be proactive from their side also. There are some agencies, ICMR, ICR, CSR. Of course, CSR journals are covered by UGC Care. That's a different matter. So that's how we should assess the quality of a journal or the article concerned published in that particular journal. Okay, right? Any other question, Ram?
No, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for taking your time.
So let me say something.
Yes, sir,
so,
please.
Once again, let me thank organizers, particularly my colleague, my friend, Kodandra, who has taken so much initiative to organize such a 5 days program, contacting so many resource persons and trying to coordinate the whole thing. And I'm happy that there were something around 150 and nearly 160 participants in this program today. Even at this juncture of closing, there are 135 participants. So thank you, Ram. Thanks all the participants. They are free to send me any queries. My number, mobile number, is 96111 65781. 96111 65781. You can contact me for any of your requirement, any of your clarifications, anything. If you need some clarification, any guidance, you are free to send me a message, or you can talk to me. If I am free, I'll be in a position to help you and guide you. Thank you so much. Thanks, the organizers, particularly the principal and my friend Ram. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your very informative and elaborated session. It included several scholarly databases. I strongly feel that attending your lecture will never go wrong, as it is packed with helpful contents to all types of scholars. So we are very lucky to have you in our program. We enjoyed it a lot, sir. And I, on behalf of PSE and from the participants group, I thank you wholeheartedly for being a part of this program and casting your knowledge upon us. Thank you so much, sir, once again.
Thank you.
Yeah, dear participants, I would like to bring it to your kind attention that many of you are not entering your roll number in the feedbacks properly. So you are making mistake in entering your roll number assigned. So please check your roll number in the PDF given on the WhatsApp group and ensure that you are entering it correctly. Thank you, Anadal. Please be reassembled at 2 o'clock.
Ram, you mentioned the speaker's name and the topic of the afternoon.
Yeah. Before. So in the afternoon, we are going to have a session on literature review by Professor Chandrasekhar from University of Mysore. He's the chairperson of Department of Library and Information Science. He'll be delivering his lecture on literature review. Please be reassembled at 2 o'clock without any fail. Thank you, Anadal.